Hi, this is Kurt at Traverse Tool Company. Today we're going to talk about getting a stubborn old broken screw out of a workpiece. So here we have three broken screws off in this workpiece, as you can see. So the first one has a hole back here. So this is a thru hole. I think that's going to be pretty easy. So I'm going to go after that one first. Then I'll get into this one up on top on here. This is a blind hole, but it shouldn't be too hard. We'll find out how that works. This one should be pretty hard though, and we'll talk more about that later. This is another blind hole, and that might give us some trouble. So let's get started on what I'm hoping is going to be the easy one first. So I'm putting a center drill in my cordless drill, trying to get pretty close to the center. And it's gonna walk around a little bit because when a bolt breaks off, it doesn't have the decency to break off smooth and flat. There's all these rough edges and angles. So it might be a little bit hard to get that drill in the center. So I'm drilling at an angle to try to get it somewhat centered. Getting there. Okay, it's not moving. I'm gonna cheat a little bit and spray some penetrating oil on it. And while I'm at it, I'm gonna spray the other ones too and just let that soak. Okay, it's not gonna come out as easy as I thought it was, so plan B is a sneaky little trick that is a left-handed center drill. Center drill is technically called a combination drill and countersink, but everybody calls it a center drill. Don't forget to reverse the drill, and let's see if I can unscrew it. And there it comes. The reason it didn't come out the first time is when it broke off, it damaged the thread so it wouldn't go all the way through. But it came out without too much trouble with that left-handed center drill. So now we're gonna see how we can do with this other one. Now that's in a blind hole, so there's no sense in going in with a right-handed center drill. I'm gonna start right off with the left-handed center drill and hope that it backs out just like that first one did. So let's see how we can do. Yep, it's coming out already. And there it is. Not too hard at all. And usually that's about all it takes. Okay, so now we have the one that I'm thinking is going to be a little bit of a struggle to get out. Sometimes a screw is broken off inside of a workpiece or whatever it might be screwed into because it's corroded or rusted in there. I put the screw in here for the purpose of removing it, so I just put it in there so it hasn't had time to rust. But what I did to kind of cheat the process a little bit is I used thread locker to hopefully somewhat simulate having corrosion or rust in there. So again, just like the second one I did, I'm gonna try this one starting off with a left-handed center drill. It's also a blind hole, so there's no point in using right-handed to see if that's gonna work. Okay, it's not going anywhere, so we have to go to another step, but I have a nice center hole drilled in there. All right, so that screw is not gonna back out easily like the other ones did, so I don't need to continue with left-handed tools. I have just a conventional right-handed drill bit. It's a 7/32. I'm just gonna go ahead and drill a hole right through this. Actually, I'm going a little bit off center, so I'm going to use a smaller drill bit. And the reason I'm doing that is to preserve the thread. Okay, the hole's through. Now I'm going to use a thread extracting tool, commonly known as an easy out. Sometimes it's not so easy that they come out, but let's see what happens. So I'm just going to put a regular tap handle on this. And there it comes. So we had to use the easy out to get the broken bolt out of the workpiece, and now that thing's stuck on the easy out. I can't get it off with my hands. An easy way to get that thing off of there, just grab a pair of pliers, hold on to it, and turn it left-handed. This has a reverse thread on it, so you can turn it to the left in order to get the screw out of there, and it comes off nice and easy. And there it is, you can use that over and over again. That came out a little bit easier than I was hoping it would have, but if you still have trouble with it, then the next thing to use is a good old torch with some fire on it. So what the heat does is it breaks up the oxidation or the rust or the thread locker, as was in my case, and it just makes it a little bit easier to come out. It might expand the metal a little bit to loosen up on the threads, but it is helpful. If that fails, the next step is to use a thread insert, and the whole thing is going to have to be drilled out and retapped in order to install a thread insert. So one of the reasons why it came out kind of easy for me is as I was drilling it, the actual drilling process heated it up a little bit. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you got something out of it. Feel free to check out our solutions page on our website for more helpful videos and articles.